One of the main motivations for the rise of virtual networking was the ossification of the internet architecture. In particular, because the internet protocol was so pervasive, it made it very difficult to make fundamental changes to the way the underlying internet architecture operated. There was a lot of work on overlay networks in the 2000s, but one-size-fits-all network architectures were very difficult to deploy. So rather than trying to replace existing network architectures, network virtualization was intended to allow for easier evolution. In other words, network virtualization enables evolution because we didn't have to pick a winner for a replacement for IP. We could instead let multiple architectures exist in parallel. Now, this was sort of a green field view of why virtual networking was potentially a good idea. In practice, network virtualization has really taken off in multi-tenant data centers, where there may be multiple tenants or applications running on a shared cluster of servers. Well-known examples of this include Amazon's EC2, Rackspace, and things like Google App Engine. Large service providers such as Google, Yahoo, and so forth also use network virtualization to adjust the resources that are devoted to any particular service at a given time.